Hi everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss about digital signal processing subject, unit 1, previous examination question paper, questions with answers. So that is R15 regulation, supplementary examination, December or January 2018 or 2019. And short answer questions in this year. Short answer questions. 1A is, if DFT of x of n is x of k, if DFT of x of n is x of k, what is the DFT of x of n minus 1? And 1B is, define circular convolution. These two are the short answer questions in digital signal processing subject in the year 2018 or 2019. December or January. And essay type questions, coming to the essay type questions, second question is, find the DFT of the sequence x of n is equal 1 by 4 whole to the power of n per n is equal to 4. And choice question is, there are two bits in choice question. First bit is state and prove time shifting property of the DFT, and second bit is find the 3 point DFT of h of n is equal 1 by 3 for n is equal to 0 to 2. And these two are the essay type questions in digital signal processing subject unit 1. So coming to the solution, first we are going to discuss about short answer solutions. Question number 1A is, if discrete Fourier transform of sequence x of n is x of k, what is the DFT of x of n minus 1? Solution. So given that the sequence x of n is x of n minus 1, so calculate discrete Fourier transform of x of n minus 1. So we know that the discrete Fourier transform of the sequence x of n is x of k using time shifting property of the discrete Fourier transform, DFT of x of n minus n naught is equal e power minus j 2 pi k n naught by capital N into x of k. Now here the shifted amount is n naught. So what is the given sequence x of n minus 1? The shifted amount is 1 second. And substitute n naught is equal to 1 second into this equation, we get discrete Fourier transform of sequence x of n minus 1 using time shifting property of DFT. So that is DFT of x of n minus 1 is equal, the shifted amount is 1 second e power minus j 2 pi k into 1 by capital N into x of k. So that is equal DFT of x of n minus 1 is equal e power minus j 2 pi k by n x of k. So this is 1A question explanation. Coming to the 1B question, define circular convolution. So what is a circular convolution? The circular convolution is also known as cyclic convolution, which is the special case of the periodic convolution, and which is the convolution of two periodic functions that have the same period, and the two sequences are having the same period. And the statement of the circular convolution property is, the convolution property of discrete Fourier transform says that multiplication of the discrete Fourier transform of two sequences is equal to the discrete Fourier transform of circular convolution of two sequences. So that is, if DFT of first sequence is x1 of k and DFT of second sequence is x2 of k, then discrete Fourier transform of circular convolution of two sequences x1 of n and x2 of n is multiplication of their DFTs. So that is x1 of k into x2 of k. So this is the property of circular convolution theorem property. Next, coming to the essay type questions, Question number 2. Find the DFT of the sequence x of n is equal 1 by 4 whole to the power of n for n is equal to 4. Now here, what is the given sequence? The given sequence x of n is equal to 1 by 4 whole to the power of n, and the length of the sequence is capital N is equal to 4 point DFT. The input sequence can be obtained by substituting n is equal to 0 to n minus 1, capital N minus 1. So now here, what is the length of the sequence? Capital N is equal to 4, and substitute capital N is equal to 4 in the length of n is equal to 0 to n minus 1, we get the small values of n is 0 to 3, and substitute small n is equal to 0 to 3 in the given sequence. If I first find out the input sequence values, so what is the given input sequence? X of n is equal to 1 by 4 whole to the power of n. In this sequence, substitute n is equal to 0, small n is equal to 0, small n is equal to 1, small n is equal to 2, and small n is equal to 3. So we get input values of x of n. So first substitute x is equal to 0 into the given sequence, we get x of 0 is equal to 1 by 4 whole to the power of 0. So 1 by 4 whole to the power of 0 is 1. Next, substitute n is equal to small n is equal to 1 into the given sequence, we get x of 1 is equal to 1 by 4 whole to the power of 1. So 1 by 4 whole to the power of 1 is 1 by 4, and 1 by 4 value is 0.25. Next, substitute n is equal to 2. So n is equal to 2, then x of 2 is equal to 1 by 4 whole square. So that is 1 by 16. So 1 by 16 is 0.0625. Next, substitute n is equal to 3, then x of 3 is equal to 1 by 4 whole cube. So 1 by 4 whole cube value is 0.0156. So these are the input sequence values. So that is the input sequence x of n is equal to 1, 0.25, 0.0625, 0.0156. So x of 0 value, x of 1 value, x of 2 value, x of 3 value. And this is x of 0 value, and this is x of 1 value, and this is x of 2 value, and this value is x of 3 value. Next, calculate DFT of the sequence. So we know that discrete Fourier transform the sequence x of n is equal to x of k, that is equal to sigma n is equal to 0 to capital N minus 1 x of n into e power minus j 2 pi k n by capital N for k is equal to 0 to capital N minus 1. So this is the definition of discrete Fourier transform of the sequence x of n. So now substitute given data. What is the given data? For n is equal to 0 to 3, what are the values of x of n? These are the values of the x of n. And the length of the sequence capital N is equal to 4, and substitute capital N is equal to 4 in this equation, we get x of k is equal to sigma n is equal to 0 to 3 x of n into e power minus j 2 pi k n by capital N. Now your capital N is 4 for k is equal to 0 to 3. So in this summation, first substitute different values of small n, so that are small n is equal to 0, small n is equal to 1, small n is equal to 2, and small n is equal to 3. So we get some expression. So that is equal, first substitute n is equal to 0, x of 0 into e power minus j 2 pi k into 0 by 4, e power minus 0, e power minus 0 value is 1, plus next substitute n is equal to 1, plus x of 1 into e power minus j 2 pi k into 1 by 4, plus next substitute n is equal to 2, x of 2 into e power minus j 2 pi k 2 by 4. Next substitute n is equal to 3. X of 3 into e power minus j 2 pi k 3 by 4. That is equal. X of 0 value is 1 plus x of 1 is 0.25. Now here the 2 2s are cancelled. Remaining exponential factor is e power minus j pi k by 2 plus x of 2 value is 0.0625 e power minus j pi k plus x of 3 value is 0.0156 into e power minus j 3 pi k by 2. In this expansion, substitute different values of k. So what are the different values of k? For k is equal to 0 to n minus 1. For k is equal to 0 to capital N minus 1. K is equal to 0 to capital N minus 1. So from the given data, what is the capital N? Capital N is equal to 4. 4 minus 1, 3. In this equation, substitute different values of k. So what are the different values of k? K is equal to 0. K is equal to 1, k is equal to 2, k is equal to 3. So we get x of 0, x of 1, x of 2 and x of 3 values. So first substitute k is equal to 0, k is equal to 0. Then x of 0 is equal 1 plus 0.25 into e power minus j pi into 0 by 2 plus 0.0625 into e power minus j pi into 0 plus 0.0156 into e power minus j 3 pi into 0 by 2. In this expansion, first substitute k is equal to 0. So that is equal. So e power minus j pi by 2 into 0, 0. And this is also e power minus 0. This is also e power minus 0. And the value of e power minus 0 is 1. So therefore, x of 0 is equal 1 plus 0.25 plus 0.0625 plus 0.0156. That is equal 1.3281. For k is equal to 0, then x of 0 value is 1.3281. Similarly, substitute remaining values of k. For k is equal to 1, next substitute for k is equal to 1, then x of 1 is equal 1 plus 0.25 e power minus j pi by 2 into 1 plus 0.0625 e power minus j pi into 1 plus 0.0156 e power minus j 3 pi by 2 into 1. So, using Euler's identity, e power minus j theta is cos theta plus j sin theta. Using Euler identity, e power j theta is cos theta plus j sin theta. So now here e power minus j pi by 2. So e power minus j pi by 2 using Euler's identity, cos pi by 2 minus j sin pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is 0 and sin pi by 2 is 1. And similarly, using Euler identity, e power minus j pi is cos pi minus j sin pi. Cos pi value is minus 1 and sin pi value is 0. And similarly, using Euler's identity, e power minus j 3 pi by 2 is cos of 3 pi by 2 minus j sin of 3 pi by 2. Cos of 3 pi by 2 is 0 and sin of 3 pi by 2 is minus 1. So that is j. So therefore, x of 1 is equal 1 minus j 0.25 minus 0.0625 plus j 0.0156. So that is equal 1 minus 0.0625 is 0.9375 minus j 0.25 plus j 0.0156 is minus j 0.2344. So this is the x of 1 value. Next substitute, k is equal to 2. For k is equal to 2, then x of 2 is equal 1 plus substitute k is equal to 2 into in this equation. Substitute k is equal to 2 into in this equation. For k is equal to 2, then x of 2 is equal to 1 plus 0.25 e power minus j pi into 2 by 2 plus 0.0625 e power minus j pi into 2 plus 0.0156 e power minus j 3 pi by 2 into 2. Now here the first term 2 2 is the cancel e power minus j pi, and second exponential term is e power minus j 2 pi, and third one is numerator and denominator in the exponential 2 is the cancel e power minus j 3 pi. Using Euler identity, e power minus j pi is cos pi minus j sin pi. Cos pi value is minus 1 and sin pi value is 0. And using Euler's identity, e power minus j 2 pi is written as cos 2 pi minus j sin 2 pi. Cos 2 pi value is 1 and sin 2 pi value is 0. Using Euler's identity, e power minus j 3 pi is written as cos 3 pi minus j sin 3 pi. Cos 3 pi value is minus 1 and sin 3 pi value is 0. So this is the expression. That is equal x of 2 is equal 1 minus 0.25 plus 0.0625 minus 0.0156. So that is equal 0.7969. Next substitute, next value of the k is equal to 3. For k is equal to 3, then x of 3 is equal 1 plus 0.25 e power minus j 3 pi by 2 plus 0.0625 e power minus j pi into 3, k value is 3 here, plus 0.0156 e power minus j 3 pi into 3 by 2. So using Euler's identity, e power minus j 3 pi by 2 value is j, and e power minus j 3 pi value is minus 1, and e power minus j 9 pi by 2 value is minus j. So that is equal, we get 0.9375 plus j 0.2344. So therefore, the DFT of the sequence is x of k is equal, x of 0 value is 1.328 and x of 1 value is 0.9375 minus j 0.2344, and x of 2 value is 0.7969 and x of 3 value is 0.9375 plus j 0.2344. So that is the DFT of the given sequence. Next choice question, third question. State and prove the time shifting property of the DFT. And second bit, find the 3-point DFT of h of n is equal to 1 by 3 for n is equal to 0 to 2. And first bit explanation. State and prove time shifting property of the discrete Fourier transform. Discrete Fourier transform. And the statement of the discrete Fourier transform is, time shifting property of the statement is, if DFT of x of n is x of k, then DFT of x of n minus n naught is e power minus j 2 pi k n naught by capital N into x of k. So this is the statement of time shifted sequence or time delayed sequence property. Now coming to the proof, we know that the inverse discrete Fourier transform is defined as or given by x of n is equal, x of n is the inverse discrete Fourier transform, x of k is the DFT of the sequence. So now consider the inverse discrete Fourier transform is x of n is equal IDFT. IDFT means inverse discrete Fourier transform of x of k is equal 1 by capital N sigma k is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of k into e power j 2 pi k n by capital N for small n is equal to 0 to n minus 1. Now here we want to calculate DFT. We want to prove that DFT of x of n minus n naught is equal this is. So this is the definition of the inverse discrete Fourier transform. This is the definition of inverse discrete Fourier transform. So in this equation, small n is replaced by n minus n naught. Small n is replaced by n minus n naught. So we get x of n minus n naught is equal 1 by capital N sigma k is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of k into e power j 2 pi k. Small n is replaced by n minus n naught e power j 2 pi k into n minus n naught by capital N. So this exponential term is written into e power ab. E power ab is written as e power a into e power b. So this exponential term is arranged as e power j 2 pi k n by capital N into e power minus j 2 pi k n naught by n. So multiplying e power j 2 pi k within the bracket term, we have e power j 2 pi k n minus j 2 pi k minus n naught by capital N. So e power a, e power a plus b, e power a plus b, that is written as e power a into e power b. So that exponential term is arranged as this. The RHS term of this equation may also be written as, may also be represented as 1 by capital N into sigma k is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of k into e power minus j 2 pi k n naught by capital N into e power j 2 pi k n by n. So using the definition of the inverse discrete Fourier transform, what is the definition of the IDFT? IDFT of x of k is equal inverse discrete Fourier transform of x of k is equal 1 by capital N sigma k is equal to 0 to n minus 1 into x of k into e power j 2 pi k n by capital N. So this is the definition of the IDFT. So using this definition, the RHS term of this equation is, the RHS term of this equation is IDFT of x of k into e power minus j 2 pi k n naught by capital N, that is equal x of n minus n naught is equal to IDFT of x of k into e power minus j 2 pi k n naught by capital N. So now taking discrete Fourier transform on both sides, we get discrete Fourier transform of LHS term is equal, on RHS side, discrete Fourier transform and inverse discrete Fourier transform is cancelled. So we get the remaining RHS term is e power minus j 2 pi k n naught by capital N into x of k. So this is the time shifted sequence, time shifted property of discrete Fourier transform. Next, coming to the second bit solution, and the second bit is given that the sequence h of n is equal to 1 by 3 for n is equal to 0 to 2, determine DFT of x h of n. Find the 3-point DFT of h of n. Okay. So we know that the DFT of the sequence is defined as DFT of x of n is x of k, that is equal sigma n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n into e power minus j 2 pi k n by n. Now here the length of the sequence capital N is 3-point DFT. So that is capital N is equal to 3. And substitute capital N is equal to 3 into this equation, we get x of k is equal to, okay, DFT of x of n is x of k. So given that what is sequence h of n? So similarly, DFT of h of n is h of k. DFT of x of n is x of k. DFT of y of n is y of k. Similarly, DFT of h of n is h of k. So that is equal sigma n is equal to 0 to, And what is the capital N? 3. 3 minus 1, 2. H of N into e power minus j 2 pi kn by capital N. Here what is the capital N? 3. See, in this equation on RHS side, substitute different values of n. So what are the different values of small n? N is equal to 0, n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2. So first substitute n is equal to 0, h of k is equal to h of 0 into e power minus 0 plus h of 1 into e power minus j 2 pi k 1 by 3 plus h of 2 into e power minus j 2 pi k 2 by 3. So for small n is equal to 0 to 3, what is h of n value? H of n value 1 by 3. For n is equal to 0 to 2, h of 0 is equal to 1 by 3, h of 1 is equal to 1 by 3, h of 2 is equal to 1 by 3. So now substitute h of 0, h of 1 and h of 2 values into here, we get h of k is equal to 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 e power minus j 2 pi k by 3 plus 1 by 3 e power minus j 4 pi k by 3. For all the terms, 1 by 3 is the common, that is equal 1 by 3 into, and the remaining factors are 1 plus e power minus j 2 pi k by 3 plus e power minus j 4 pi k by 3. So that is h of k value. So according to the definition of the DFT, if DFT of x of n is x of k, that is equal to sigma n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n into e power minus j 2 pi k n by n. So for k is equal to, what is the range of the k? For k is equal to 0 to n minus 1. Here what is the capital N? 3 point DFT. K is equal to 0 to 2. So, in this equation, substitute k is equal to 0, k is equal to 1, k is equal to 2. So, next calculate h of 0 value, h of 1 value, h of 2 value. So, first substitute k is equal to 0. For k is equal to 0, then h of 0 is equal to 1 by 3 into 1 plus e power minus 0 plus e power minus 0. E power minus 0 value is 1. So therefore, 1 plus 1, 3. 3 by 3 is 1. Next substitute k is equal to 1 into this equation. Then h of 1 is equal to 1 by 3 plus 1 into e power k is equal to 1. E power minus j 2 pi by 3 plus e power minus j 4 pi by 3 using Euler's identity. What is the Euler's identity? E power minus j theta is cos theta plus j sin theta. Using that Euler's identity, the value of e power minus j 2 pi by 3 is minus 0.5 minus j 0.8, and the value of e power minus j 4 pi by 3 is minus 0.5 plus j 0.8. That is equal 1 by 3 into 1 minus 0.5 minus j 0.8 plus into minus 0.8 plus j 0.8. Minus j 0.8 plus j 0.8 is cancelled. Minus j 0.8 and plus j 0.8 is cancelled. Minus 0.5, minus 0.5, minus 1 and plus 1, minus 1 is cancelled. And what is the remaining term? 1 by 3 into 0. 1 by 3 into 0, 0. Next substitute h is equal to k is equal to 2, then h of 2 is equal 1 by 3 into 1 plus e power minus j 4 pi by 3 plus e power minus j 8 pi by 3. So using Euler's identity, the value of e power minus j 4 pi by 3 is minus 0.5 plus j 0.8, and e power minus j 8 pi value is minus 0.5 minus minus j 0.8. So that is equal, here also plus j 0.8 minus j 0.8 is cancelled, minus 0.5 minus 0.5 minus 1, plus 1 and minus 1 is cancelled, and the total value is 0, 0 by 3, 0. So therefore, the sequence h of k, DFT of the sequence h of n is h of k is equal 1 comma 0 comma 0. So this value is h of 1 value, this value is h of 2 value, this value is h of 3 value.